everyone. Week in review again, and it's Wednesday, so, you know, the whole deal is everything that I've done the past week. Well, I'm trying to be as humble as possible. I know in the past, forget it. You know about me in the past. I don't need to bring it back up. So the big thing is, you know that I had Fabiac, and that's my big deal. I mean, that's what happened in the past week, was Fabiac. The Face and Body Art International Convention, put on by Marcella Murad and Heather Banks of Silly Farm. And this was their 10th year anniversary. I am glad I was a part of it. Okay? Now, I have a few video clips to show you and stuff. And I guarantee this is not going to be a short video because I have so much to tell you guys. And there is so much more that I put on the blog for you to see. So, you know, when you're watching this video, if you're watching it on YouTube, click the link down below in the info to go to my blog so that you can read everything that's down below this video in my blog. And just want to tell you right up quick, you know, got a bag from them with my name tag. We'll just put in, there were a few complaints. We had this wristband that would allow us to, you know, get into the convention and everything so that people knew who we were. But the problem is, not everybody was carrying around these bags. And if you look, there's a little slot up here and it has my information in it. It tells me my name. Well, because not a lot of people carry this around, you don't have any name tags on your shirts. So, it probably would have been better if we could have had some clip-on tags, put that card into the tag if we're not carrying around the bag. That way people can know us, but there was a little confusion in that. So, but other than that, I mean, it went off really good. Got my shirt, as you see, right here. Fits me, nice, large, black. Yeah, pink is my color, so, you know, thanks, Marcella. Thanks, Heather, you know, for choosing pink as the color for the shirt. Love it. And as I promised, I have two shirts here. Another large. Okay. This is going to you, Kim. So if you're watching this video, give me your address so I know where to send it to. The other one, if I'm correct, and my mind freaks on me a little bit, is Angie Mazzara. Now, I was going to show you your shirt and ask you if it's the right one. I'm going to send it to you anyways. You tell me. We don't need to let people know. I'm sorry, that sounded really bad, but I mean, I'm trying to save face here. I'm sorry. It was really great. I mean, first clip I'm going to show you real quick is just the road trip. I know it's really stupid to do this, but I want to show it to you anyways. And here's the thing. Because this is a video, you can fast forward through and get through these parts real quick and easy. So if I get a chance, I'll try to put a little annotation up in the video. That way you can skip ahead to the next part and if you want to. It's up to you. So, but this is why the video is going to be really long and stuff, because I have all these little parts that I want to put in. There's some funny parts. There's some not so funny parts. The only videos that I'm not going to show you in this whole video here are classes. I did make the mistake, and I signed a waiver saying that I cannot record any classes. Well, I made the mistake, and I did record part of some classes. I'm only stating this because I think it's the right thing to do, you know. But I'm not going to post them for anybody to see. These are going to be for my reference only, nobody else's. So, and unless you were actually there and you took the class, you know, it's not right to give out stuff. If you really want to see the classes, you guys need to get there and go next year. So, the first little snippet that I have is our little road trip on our way there. And is what I did is I actually took my Android phone and this little guy here. And I did Facebook check-ins at every stop that we made so people can track where I was going and how far I was. And I was surprised with the feedback from it. That was pretty cool. I took some pictures. And if you notice, well, here, just take a look.
South Carolina. Okay, we're heading down south. We're in South Carolina, and we stopped off at the Welcome Center, and I have just noticed something. You're only allowed to use the restroom between the hours of 5:30 p.m. and 9 a.m. So, I guess we can't use the restrooms.
So, you notice that in the video, I know it said, it was kind of funny the way we stopped off at this rest stop and it said restrooms, 5:30 p.m. to 9 a.m. And that seemed kind of weird to me because, you know, I understand the building's closed and stuff, but for idiots out there, they're going to read that, they're going to say, dang, I need to go to the bathroom, and it's in the middle of the day, and you can't use it until 5:30 p.m. I just thought that was kind of funny, so, you know, I had to put that little part in there. But that was our little road trip, and, I mean, we drove all the way. It was 12 hours, and we did take a hotel room the night of the 24th. That way we could be there on the morning of the 25th for the pre-day classes that we had, and it was pretty neat. I mean, I had a great time. I learned a lot. I wish I could have taken more than one pre-day class because, yes, I took the Yolanda Bartram's class, and I did the prosthetics, and that was great and everything like that. I wish I also could have taken Nick and Brian's, you know, body painting class or one of the other classes. I mean, it was just unbelievable the amount of information that we got. So here's a little snippet about the pre-day stuff that went on. So take a look at this.
We made it. We're finally here. And we're going to get checked in.
Excuse me.
You know you beat my Jerry.
You know I'm videotaping.
I am so okay with that.
And you know, I don't edit the volume either.
That's all right. I have nothing to be ashamed of.
So anything you say will be recorded and can be used against you in a court of law.
Awesome.
Just gonna come up from the other right arm.
Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. If you do not understand these rights, because I've read them to you.
You know that all too well.
Seriously. With your good heart, Daniel.
Now drop your jaw. There you go.
Oh!
I love the ear, though.
Getting my boobs, aren't you?
Well, I'm matching more up there.
There.
You want to get yours with my...
That's going on YouTube, you know that. Next Wednesday. That actually looks good. Oh, they only did your front? Just want to get the full effect. There you go. That is awesome.
Yeah, kind of like, so we can buy, I can buy one.
Is this the one you did?
Yeah.
This is awesome.
Thank you.
I love it.
It evolved, didn't it?
No.
It started off as one thing and kind of went a different way.
I love the face. Face matches nice.
Thank you.
I like the way you did the cheekbones, too.
Aww. All right. Yeah, do that.
Yellow is a good color on you.
Yeah.
Let's get some movement in that.
Okay, you saw all that. I know. I have a little post-it that I'm trying to get all my information off of and stuff. And honestly, I can't remember everything that's in the videos. I know I pre-made them and stuff like that, so if I screw up, bear with me. Because trying to get this all done in the short amount of time so that you guys can see it, I don't have time to go back and review every single video that I compile together, or the little snippets. So, but the other thing was, we had some really great vendors there. Lamari Malo and Alex Hansen have put together their company, and they premiered at Fabiac in the vendor room with their extreme makeup and body art store and stuff. And they had some really great t-shirts and some brushes and all kinds of stuff that were really neat. Even these hair gems that are really cool. And that was pretty awesome. And one vendor that wasn't really there but was doing it, if you see it, it's in my hair. There's a feather. I've washed my hair at least 6 times already, and it's still there, and it's still pretty cool, and it's a really neat thing. And I think I'm going to start doing that in my area with these feathers because they look really cool. Even on a guy, it looks pretty cool and stuff. And she did it with kind of a tiger stripe theme. So if you really can see it and stuff, and it's just, there's that one piece, but I mean, there's a second, let me see if I can pull it out a little bit without all the rest of the hair. But there's another feather in there, and it really, you know, makes it pop out. You know, it's got that small little feather there. So I had some fun, and everybody really liked it. And here's a little video about the vendor room and stuff that was going on inside there. So take a look at this.
Thank you.
the vendor room. I know you really want to see the jams and what all went on in the jams and stuff. And we had the Mad Hatter's jam the very first night, which, not the pre-day, it was the 26th, it was Thursday. We had the Mad Hatter jam, and everybody made their own hats and different things. And, I mean, they really went out, and they had a Mad Hatter competition. So whoever had the best hat won, you know, a prize and different things. And we had different raffles going on and all kinds of stuff. And it was just really cool. There was some great face paintings in there. I did a couple face paintings. I really wish I would have done some more, but instead my ego got in the way. I'm trying to do this whole book thing that you guys know about. And I was looking for artists to paint me. Yes, if you want to say it, I know it sounds really bad, but I'm a paint whore. I love to be painted. I paint other people. I just don't get the chance unless I'm painting myself, which is no fun. I like to see what other people do. So, you know, I was doing my whole thing about getting other artists to paint me up as a feline. And I did do that, and we got some really great artists. And I know I broke some promises to some people that really wanted to get painted by me because they've seen what I did on these YouTube videos and on Facebook. But I promise you, next year, if I go, the book's going to be out of the way, so I'm going to have more time for you guys, and I will paint you up. I'm going to improve because I've learned a lot from you guys, too. So the jams were just awesome, and I had the best experience in the world. I got Athena Z to paint me up for this book, and it is an awesome piece. And you'll see some pictures down below in the blog, not in the info bar if you're watching on YouTube. You got to go to my blog, so click on that link, and you can go to my blog. She did a leopard face with, you know, instead of my whole body like a leopard, she did it to where it looked like I was a leopard on top of some branches, and it was really cool. And that was a big hit, and you'll see some other things. See some other pictures. You can go to YouTube. I mean, you can go to Facebook, and you can search Fabiac 2011, and you'll see a whole bunch of pictures up there. Go to my profile. I have a whole bunch of them tagged of me, and you can really see that. So let me get to the video about the jams, and you can see what these other people are really painting, and that are really cool. You can even see Erica X-Line painting me a little bit for my book, too. So watch this a little bit.
Our shirt raffle winners, they're going to be holding up their shirts in just 2 minutes. And you can see their finished product in just a couple minutes. We'll be holding them up there. Deidre, please come up to the DJ. Deidre, to the DJ, please.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, kind of loose and short of the field.
shutter closes.
Yes, he did. And his leaning forward just gave it a better kick. All right, let's get one over there.
Got the next definition under the chin. Let's take those together.
Come on.
Model, Mr. Kathmandu.
So what did you guys think? Did you think it was pretty cool? You thought it was awesome? I thought it was cool. I mean, tons and tons and tons of people. And I mean, just the amount of creativity and ingenuity and imagination that has to come to create these awesome, wonderful works of art is just unbelievable. I mean, I learned a lot. I had to put my ego aside and really learn from the best. Please, thank you. We're just in the air. I mean, even though we know we can take pictures of each other, even though we know each other in that convention, we still ask each other politely for different things. And that's what I loved about the place. Everybody was so polite, so humble, so modest. I mean, the best of the best. We have our celebrities in our industry, you know, Nick and Brian, Genevieve Hull, Brady, I'm not going to say your last name because I keep screwing it up, and I know you watch these videos, so you can beat me up the next time, okay? So, thanks, Brady. Brady the Great, that's what I'm going to call him. Right next to Katie the Great, you're Brady the Great. Kim Brennan, awesome. She did a piece on my back that just blew my mind. And with the help of Jenny, she really improved upon it. And, I mean, it really brought it out to be something she didn't even expect. And I'm actually very honored to be her model for that class that we did. And I mean, Nick Herrera was there. These are our celebrities, but they don't want to be known as celebrities. They don't want people to come up to them, shake their hand and worship them and say, thank you, you have inspired me, and do it like that. Go up to them, say, hey Nick, hey Brian, what's up man, how's it going, you know, your work is great, can you show me some stuff? I mean, I want to show you this that I do. They just want to be friends. They don't want to have, you know, this whole bit about, oh, you are the best, I worship you. Most of the time, these celebrities that we look at in our industry are very modest. Some of them have an ego, some of them don't. But most of them like to walk around the jams. They like to look at the stuff that we do. They like to get inspiration from it. Margie Cantor even said that she walks around the jams and she's like, wow, I've never seen that before. I'm going to have to try that and learn from that. And this is from a novice, not from an expert, not from an advanced face painter or body painter. This is from a beginner that has been only doing it for maybe a year. And they just blow people's minds, you know. One person who did that and who got an award during the gala presentation, which I'll show you that snippet in just a little while. Her name is Samantha Barco from Utah. She goes by Sammy Barco. And she entered into the face painting contest just like I did. Okay? And she won second place in semi-pro, which I was also a semi-pro. Even though I've been doing it for 10 years, I had never been to the convention before. I didn't know what to expect. So instead of trying to go in for pro and really look like an idiot, I went in for semi-pro and still looked like an idiot. And I'll tell you about that after I get done with this. But Sammy Barco is just unbelievable. She did this awesome piece. She won second place. She also is her and her friend Miriam are both, they couldn't decide on either of them because they worked so well together and they kept a happy and pleasant attitude. I mean, they were just so uplifting. They got Up and Coming Artist of the Year award. So, I mean, she won two awards, really great. Miriam, her friend, is an awesome artist too. She just happened to do a lot more modeling than doing art, but other than that, she was really, really great. And I'm glad I'm friends with Sammy Barco. She actually painted my face for the gala. And, I mean, she did a wonderful job. It was the head of the party, and I told everybody who did it. And, I mean, she is just really, really great. I actually consider her my sister I never had. Since I'm an only child, I have actually found somebody who I can relate to, who is actually the same age as me, too. And she is just wonderful. She has two kids of her own, a husband who loves her. They've been married for 12 years, and they are just, I mean, I could just imagine with her personality how great the rest of her family is. And I'm just glad to be good friends with her now, and I'm glad to be good friends with everybody. But, like I was saying about the face painting competition, you've seen my work on YouTube. You've seen my work on Facebook. You know what I can do. So why didn't I do it? Take a look at this picture, okay? The one I'm showing you right now. What is wrong with me? Why? Why did I do this? The theme of it was Painters in Wonderland, Explosion of Color. Look at how bland it is. I let my ego, I let myself, you know, I rushed through it. I didn't take my time. I didn't think it through. I can blame it on everything else. I can blame it on the lack of paints that I had because I can guarantee I had less paint than anybody else there, and I didn't have the money to go out and buy new from the vendor. I wish I did. I would have bought out the whole vendor room if I had the opportunity. I just didn't. I was on a budget. So, but if you look, I could have gone a whole lot better. I should have gone with pinks and purples. The girl had great purple hair. I should have left the hat off and just done the face. I thought the hat would be good because, you know, it was like a Mad Hatter style. If I would have done it a little bit differently, the hat probably would have matched a little bit better. I should have added more color to it. I should have done this and that. But I thought, you know, hey, I'm Kathmandu. I'll do my thing. I'll place somewhere. And I don't know where I placed, but I'm very disappointed in myself, and I'm sorry I disappointed everybody there who expected a lot more of me. And, I mean, I'm really starting to learn a lot more about myself from this whole convention because, I don't know, I'm becoming a better person because of it, all right? If you read the blog, you'll understand. I mean, I don't know if I can if I could have said anything better than I did in the blog. Let me know if I left out anything, but, you know, hey, on a lighter side, though, I mean, next year, if I do go again, it's the Bollywood theme, so I'm going to be doing research now. I'm going to make sure that I get into registration. I'm going to go for the pro face painting competition and for the body paint competition, and I'm going to research everything. I'm going to take everything that I learned from this past weekend at Fabiac, and I'm going to use it to my advantage, and I'm going to build myself up and become a better person from everything that I learned from everybody there, and a better artist at that too. So you're going to see some newer works as the year goes on with these videos every Wednesday. You're going to see some bigger and better stuff in my blog. Because I'm going to take everything that I learned, and I'm going to take my time with it, and I'm going to make sure I get it right, and I'm not going to put out any lesser quality work, because I'm just that way. I don't want to, you know, be known as the egotistical bastard who thinks he's the best in the world. And for some reason, I actually think I am that way a little bit, and I really don't mean to be. I just speak my mind, and I like to be helpful. But sometimes being helpful can be an annoyance too. So I'm working on that. Now, I do want to show you a little video, and if you notice, it's going to be kind of like this. It's going to be sideways. Bear with it. I wasn't thinking when I videotaped it, but watch the expressions on my face. Because in this video, it's one that Margie Cantor did for the first time. She had never painted this design, and she incorporated the butt head that I have. Watch this video.
Any math class. These Ben Nye Luminaire powders. If you have nothing else in your kit, get a set of these. Summertime sweaty, this is great. There's a ladybug in the book that I do on the eye. I use paint sometimes in the summer. I'll use this pink for the ladybug because then it doesn't sweat off.
What company is this?
Ben Nye. Again, all of these things can be bought at Silly Farm. I use these little smoothie blenders. This is what you apply this with. So she's already got the yellow on top of her eye. I'm going to take the yellow there.
You get Ben Nye at theater makeup stores, too.
So
So what did you think? I thought it was kind of funny, too. I asked her, I saw her, I said, hey, Margie, can you do like a tiger or a cat on my face? And she kind of looked at me. She goes, well, wow, you have that crack right there. Hey, I got an idea. Yeah, we could do something with that. So I went into her class. It was actually a demo class. It was the very last class of the whole convention. And it was, you know, pick your nose demo class. So she brought me up and she did that whole lion on my nose and stuff with the, what was it, tail coming up and everything like that. I mean, it was great. I had fun with that and everybody loved it and stuff. And I hope you got a kick out of that. I made sure I took some pictures so that they can post it on the Fabiac website when they post all those pictures up. And I mean, it was fun doing that. But the last video clip I really have to show you is the actual gala itself. Now, I didn't film the whole thing. All I did was I just filmed walking around a little bit, you know, showing the different people at different tables. I know it seems a little dark in the beginning, but is what I did is I actually did turn on the night, you know, feature. So it didn't show a light, but it actually brightened it up a little bit by adjusting the exposure. And you'll see the different people around there and the different body paintings and everything else. So here you go. Take a look. When I found out I didn't win, but Sammy Barco won second place in the semi-pro face painting competition, and my other good friend Erica, she won first place in the professional face painting category. It's the second time she's competed. It's the first time she's won first place. She was crying with tears of joy, and we were all happy for her. And she did great work, and you can check out those photos on YouTube, too. She did really great. We hit the road right afterwards, just about midnight, and hit the road to go home, and now I'm home, as you see with the video. But if you don't want to look at all the photos that I have on my Facebook, which are easier to see, you notice how I usually post a lot of photos below of the events. I had over 520 photos. I'm not putting them in the blog. Not individually, at least. So what I did is I did go through One True Media, and I created different little video montages of the photos that I had taken while I was there. I wanted to take photos of everybody. There's even a little video montage of me with other face painters and stuff, which some of them you should recognize. I just wasn't able to get a hold of everybody. I missed out on getting with Lamari Malot, Alex Hansen, Nick and Brian, Mark Reed, Pasher House, a couple other people that I really wanted to take pictures with. But I'll do that next time, because there will be a next time and I will be able to get pictures with them. So I will have a collection of Kathmandu with somebody else. But that was fun. So go ahead and look down below at those videos and take a look at some of the pictures and stuff. I tried to pick the best music to fit each little thing, but you'll notice it's the categories I have them in really fit what the photos are. So I hope you enjoy those and you can watch those. So last but not least, before I end this video, I just want to tell everybody thank you. I want to tell Heather Banks and Marcella Murad, thank you for putting on this convention. It was the best convention of my life. I've been trying to go for 10 years and I finally got there, and I was welcomed with open arms, hugs, just complete and utter kindness and candor amongst everybody there. There was not one person who shunned away from anything. I mean, you say hi, they'll give you a hug instead of a handshake, and I love that. Thank you everybody for putting up with me. I know because of my videos and everything, you could have just walked the other direction when you saw me, but instead you left all the negativity at home. You came up, you gave me a hug, you thanked me for my videos. In fact, most of the time when I walked into a room, everybody knew who I was in the first place. You know, hey, I finally met Daniel, I met Kathmandu. And that makes me feel really great that I do have a following of people that are watching these videos and following me on Facebook. And it makes a difference in my life because it makes me a better person. But the thing is, I really love how everybody is teaching each other everything. If you go to ask them a question, they'll give you the answer. They won't say, oh, get away from me. They will actually say, yeah, sit down, let me show you. I love that. And I just want to say thank you to everybody who has been kind, who's been nice enough to teach me what they know, nice enough to listen to me, even if it was, and I know I shouldn't have done it, even if it was a complaint or a problem that I had. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being just wonderful people. I really appreciate it. And I hope to see you guys next year, because I am going to work on going next year and being that better person for you. And any promises that I broke in, I know I told people that, hey, come to the jam, I'll paint you, because they were asking me, and I just didn't get around to it. I promise you next year, I won't be doing my book, so I'll be able to do all those paintings. Just really, guys, thanks. Thanks for being such wonderful people. And I know I have my subscription-based website for my tutorials, which I have been lapsing on and stuff. I was going to work on it at the convention, but I didn't have internet access, so that really sucked. But if you guys really want to check out something good, go to fabatv.com, okay? Subscribe to their tutorials. They have some of the best artists in the world. Wiser Owner, Pasture House, Nick and Brian, Margie Cantor, Heather Banks, Marcella's doing her classes, Jenny's doing her classes, Brady, whole bunch of other, Brady the Great, whole bunch of other people are just getting in there. I know they made a comment to me, actually, about, you know, doing something with FABA. And they even thanked me for promoting it for them, which I have no problem doing because there's really no issue involved with promoting another company. I see it as a good faith. If I help you guys out, I hope that you'll help me out too. I know that doesn't work in this world nowadays all the time, but, you know, I believe in karma, and if you do good to somebody, it'll come back to you. And that's just what I'm hoping. So, go to FABA TV. I haven't checked it to see if they changed it yet, but I know they were still taking subscriptions there, and I believe it is still at $24.99 a month right now, if you get in on this deal right now, or $250 a year, which is a really great price for everything that you get. This is way more professional than I'm doing. You're going to love this. I'm telling you, if you saw my video last week about FABA TV, it was just unbelievable. I mean, that just blew my mind. So, guys, if you haven't subscribed to me and you do want to subscribe to something, go to FABA TV. Subscribe. Learn. You get 6 videos a month. And, you know, as long as you're subscribed, those videos don't disappear. You're still able to see them and watch them. So, go to FABA TV. Check that out. And other than that, now I'm starting to ramble. I just want to say thank you, guys. You were the best. If you didn't get to go, you need to go. This is a great place. You'll meet a lot of people, have a lot of fun, and just really learn a lot. So, thanks for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe if you haven't. Leave a comment down below in my blog or on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, wherever you have to. Let me know what you think about this video. Sorry I didn't do a face painting during it like I did the past couple of ones. I just really had too much information and not enough time to paint my face. I can't multitask really good like Heather Banks can. So, just, you know, rate, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think, and I'll talk to you guys next Wednesday. Happy painting.